Marco, who are you fighting next, and are you ever going to fight in Carson or Ontario?
I don't know who I'm fighting next. They're working on finalizing Juan Carlos Burgos for January the 25th. Most likely it'll be him.
In New York?
In New York. Am I ever going to fight in Carson or Ontario? It's up to Bob Arum. Maybe Carson. Ontario, they don't do shows there.
How many war fought there?
Not Bob Arum, though.
No, he's Goosen.
Not Bob Arum, yeah, but, yeah.
No, but that's Goosen.
Bob Arum can't make a fight.
I may fight Carson, maybe.
Hugo Cruz, when are you fighting a big name like Gamboa? Big name. Juanma, Rocky, they're both world champs. Salido, world champs. I guess not.
I find nothing but no names. See, people don't understand that as you're developing as a fighter, they bring in the fighters, tests, you know, and rugged guys. Not everybody makes it to be 33-0. If it was that easy, everybody would be doing it.
You're right.
You know, and some of these tests, people fail. I've passed all of them. Little by little, you're developing, becoming a better fighter. And now that I am where I'm at, you know, all those fights definitely have helped. Even if they're no names. I've always said, one of my toughest fights was one of those tests. It was when I fought at the Palms. I fought Jose.
You got the guy that fought at the Palms on Blue Claudio Duda.
He was USBA champion. He was on a winning streak. He had just beat like 20 feet of fighters and, you know, won the USBA champion. People won't know who he is, but that guy was my, up until now even, he's been my toughest fight, my toughest opponent. After beating, you know, the undefeated fighters, he came to win.
Yeah.
And he gave me one of my toughest fights. Jose, I can't remember his last name though, but I remember, you know?
Robert Arellano, what part of Michoacán is your family from, and can you whoop on Robert?
Hey, Robert, they want to see you on Mikey's Power.
Me and Mikey? Why would they?
I don't know. That's what they asked.
Tell them to beat up their mama first.
Charge them.
We're from.
It's going to cost them some money.
Pay-per-view.
Pay-per-view.
Oh, that's a Hollywood answer.
Bare knuckle.
Yeah, that's a Hollywood answer.
We're from Michoacán, from the Rancho de Urequio, pertenece a Panindícuaro.
A small ranch?
Yeah, un rancho, small ranch. Well, it's not small.
It's all big now.
It's big now, a lot of population. It grew.
The city now?
It grew as in not just the
population.
But they have roads, they have internet, they have Wi-Fi in there.
Oh, you've
they
been
have,
there?
Yeah. I've been there a lot of times.
Really?
Yeah. It just it expanded
time,
big
go.
Time.
All right, we'll go next time. I'm going to
get killed, but you know,
it's okay.
Make it back.
It's okay, I'm down.
Probably get this.
Get kidnapped out there.
It's okay.
They see you, why they're gonna think that you got a lot of money. Yeah. You're Jew. You figure you got money.
They saw that video of Freddie Roach, so for sure they're gonna try to kidnap me, huh?
They're probably gonna like you, maybe, because of the Mexican thing. You're Jamaican.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Might like you. Don Flaviano. What's up, Mikey? Are you going to train with Alex for your next fight?
We start training next week. I'll start training next week. So we're definitely going to use him.
He's chilling. We show up. He's like, what's up, Pita? I was like, what's up, Bonz? He's like, when's training camp?
You had a good time, Bonbon.
Liked it.
He's pretty. It's good. The highest?
At least he's hanging out with us, staying busy, you know, keeping doing something, you know, without him being all over the place, getting in trouble. You know, he's got something to look for. He's looking forward to go to the gym. He's calling me, hey, you're gonna pick me up. He's texting me, hey, can I go run with you guys? You know, what time? You know, he's looking forward to that, so that's always good.
You already know.
Keep him on track.
Good that he's around. Robert Arellano again. he said what we always say. You're all right, Ellie. I don't care what Brandon says about you being gay. You know how we say that? You ever heard us say that? I told Nano that. I was like, hey, Nano, you know what? You're pretty cool. I don't care what the Big G says about you. He's like, what does the Big G say? Like, all that. I'm like, I just get it. Mike says, Ellie Sekbak sleeps in Robert Garcia's gym.
Okay. I'm in New Hampshire. How could I be sleeping in the gym?
Yeah.
Figure that one out.
Ruben, I mean, this kind of